Season 5, Episode 4, Puzzle, Rubble, Toy, and Trouble.
Good morning, fellow patrons of the Company Holler Company store. Don't mind us, we're just dressed in the company uniform, perusing the wares on our lunch break.
Chip, stop being so conspicuous. You don't have to tell everybody your fake life story. And stop drawing attention to our disguises.
Our disguises are very good. We look just like the other Company Holler workers, except your helmet doesn't look right. It's kind of sitting on top of your hair.
Your hair is just as tall as mine. We both look like lighthouses.
Ooh, Nita, look, they're selling headlamp blingos. For the low price of 200 Company Holler dollars, you could have a teddy bear dangling from your headlamp.
Whoop, here comes Ms. Weaver. Let's turn back this way and look very hard at the blingo display so she doesn't see us spying.
Yes, Tarantula. I'm at the company store now. I'm going to be the first in line for the final Country Rock Critter collectible. Excuse me, Straw Ma'am. Am I the first in line for the Halloween Country Rock Critter unveiling?
Yes, line form's here.
I'm so excited! Believe me when I tell you, Tarantula, I'm the most dedicated employee at Company Holler. And it's all because I've got to collect all the darling figurines. They're so lucky to have me here.
Ah, hold on. Let me log into the app so I can mine more Company Holler dollars while I'm waiting. Do you think we ought to try to convince Mrs. Weaver to leave Company Holler and join our rebellion?
She'd be a real asset. I mean, you know, once you can get her to pay attention.
She does tend toward distractedness. It out and out gives me the fantods.
That's a really weird thing to say, Chip. I think you may have spent too much time in that carriage with Roostifer Batsinger.
Speaking of, here comes his weird little son.
I hate the weird little son. Do you think he'll recognize you?
I hope not.
Make way for the number one boy. I want that Country Rock Critter, and my daddy said I could have the first one.
That's nonsense, little Percy. I'm already in line. You could be the second in line, which is still very, very good.
My daddy said I could have the first one, and she's talking to me like I'm one of the sorry people.
He can have it. He first in line.
Oh.
He seems pretty distracted.
Mrs. Weaver, talk to me like we're friends, but don't say my name.
Chip Clearly, is that you? When did you two come to work for Company Holler? And why don't you have any cute little blingos for your drab headlamps? Give me a break!
We don't work here. We just wanted to come here and check up on things. Are you okay?
Never better. I'm by far the best employee here. I built an elaborate web system for sorting fright ore. I'm chair spider of the social events committee, and I'm the only one thus far who has collected all the Country Rock Critters.
Well, that's nice to hear, Mrs. Weaver, but are you sure you're okay here? It seems like you work pretty much nonstop. Don't you want to come back to Curdle Holler and enjoy your retirement?
Well, maybe, Chip Clearly, I don't know. Maybe I will after they unveil the final figurine. Ta-ta!
Chip, I give up. Let's just get out of here before anybody sounds the alarm. Like that little Percy creep who is now covered in blingos for some reason.
I get all the blingos, I get all the blingos.
I just got a text alert that says I'm supposed to sign for something back at the boutique.
From Carrion Carriers? I think that's Pumpkin's new video game console.
Why did he have it sent to my home and not his?
I don't know, but I've got dibs on player two. Let's walk fake casually out of here.
Video game.
Y'all in Curdle Holler.
Curdle Holler, Curdle Holler.
Curdle Holler, Curdle Holler.
Curdle Holler, Curdle Holler.
Curdle Holler, Curdle Holler.
Yeah.
Curdle Holler, Curdle Holler.
Curdle Holler, Curdle Holler.
Curdle Holler, Curdle Holler.
Welcome to, welcome to Bootiful, Bootiful. Spooky cool, spooky cool. Curdle Holler.
Curdle Holler, Curdle Holler. Holler.
Baby, Curdle Holler, Curdle Holler.
Curdle Holler, Curdle Holler.
Curdle Holler, Curdle Holler.
Welcome to your afterlife.
Mr. Chip, I got a question.
Almost done, buddy, I promise. Just need to run some more wire to this RF boo adapter, and you'll be the proud owner of a brand new bony Gravestation.
It's a big day for me.
I heard a news report that video games excite areas of the brain responsible for violence, sass talk, and paranoia.
But not my game. It's rated P for pumpkin.
Oregon Entrail, a sojourn to misery.
From what I could tell, you're supposed to see how fast you can get dysentery from eating entrails on the way to Oregon.
A noble quest, but why pursue it here in the middle of my boutique?
So y'all can see me play it and bring me snacks.
Might as well use the showroom, since we had to shut down the store for rebel purposes.
Yow! Yes, even now, a full braid of strawmen is combing the street. No doubt on heightened alert after their failure to transport the library to Earth. They must be keen to sniff out rebels and conscripts for the mines.
I heard they told Ms. Huntsman that one of the Country Rock Critters needed a good night tuck in, followed him right into the mine.
I heard the same from Mr. Fly, who also shared that Roosterfer now plans to disappear the Von Snap Pyramid.
Well, that's rude.
Indeed.
Yay!
You're all set up. Give it a go, Pumpkin.
I got the first game.
Percy.
Hey, who are you?
Percy, what are you doing here?
I'm first. I know all the moves and the secret level.
I know it too. I know the secret level.
Oh yeah? Where is it?
In my heart.
No, it ain't, idiot.
Granddaddy, tell him let me play it. It's for Pumpkin. It's my Gravestation. She's the fastest girl, fastest in the land, and the prettiest, and the best at pulling carts. That's my girl. It's... Say her name, y'all.
Julie.
Julie, baby.
Now, Miss Von Wangencamp, when you told me we were taking a long ride in a pull cart with this old mule, I expected a rustic experience. But had I known you were planning a whole sing-along like we were your little camp friends, I may have petitioned for a more dignified means of transportation.
Well, that's a fair thing to say, Belfry. But we are traveling to a little shack out in the middle of the muck forest where cars get stuck. But not Julie. She won't get stuck. She don't need a road. She's a good cart girl.
Bonita, would you like me to turn on the radio app on my bone phone?
I would not.
Very well. Would you at least like to inform Mr. Batsinger of your plan? I sense he is eager to know where we are going and why.
I'm about as curious as an old maid with a handsome new neighbor.
Barf on that simile, Belfry, but okay, let's chat. I hold in my hand a creepy little box. This box was given to Chip by Roosterfer Batsinger.
A caretaker's vault, which cannot be opened without three caretakers present. Inside is my offer to you all in exchange for your full cooperation with Company Holler.
A caretaker's vault. It's some kind of magical box that requires three present or former caretakers to open.
Well now, isn't that a twisted little trinket box? I don't believe I've ever seen one of these.
I found a reference to this item in an ancient town codex. Inside this box is a scroll that proposes massive changes to the town. Once locked, The box requires 3 caretakers to open it, and 3 caretakers must sign the scroll for its proposal to take effect.
Yep, and Roosterfer thinks that he's going to be all cool inviting us to go to his dumb office and then probably trying to make us drink some gross old-timey cocktail and eat weird hors d'oeuvres off of gross crackers with too many seeds. And then he'd be all,
"If you're ready, let us open the caretaker vault and consider my weird scheme."
And make a big show out of opening it, but...
You've reached Albert Ghost. I'm in a meditative trance right now, but I'd be happy to call you back when I've reached enlightenment.
My daddy doesn't know about Albert Ghost.
That's right, Belfry. As far as Roosterfer knows, the vault could only be opened by himself, you, and Bonita.
Yep. We have a whole caretaker up our sleeve. So, Belfry, me, you, and Albert, the dream team, are going to open this caretaker vault to get a jump on whatever idiotic thing Roosterfer is trying to pull here.
Just as soon as Julie gets us to Albert's meditation shack.
Meditation shack, baby.
Yeah!
Can't take y'all nowhere.
Go, Julie, go. Oh, Julie, go. She goes super fast. Well, she goes kind of slow.
Yet Julie has stopped to sniff a toad.
Yes, Master. We obey your every command.
Thank you.
Hey, let me try.
Only I can do it.
Then make him eat boogers.
Okay, we got to ask polite.
And make him punch his own butt. And make him...
Well, the dungeon display is ruined, and there's chocolate all over the hair shirts, so we'll have to mark those down. But I did secure the specimen jars, so they should be safe until he finds them. Which he will.
Very good. Our guest has moved on to the Ouija board.
Those boogers taste good.
Oh, I thought Percy was all about that Gravestation. He knows all the cheat codes. I don't know if you heard.
He wants anything he can't have, which is problematic, because he's not properly afraid of threats.
And you can't make him leave. You saw him fly into that crawl space where he knows I can't get to.
He's a monster.
Hey, kid, look what I can do.
No, because you're doing too much for attention right now.
Whatever.
This is unsustainable. We must call his father.
Well, we can, but Bat Senior suspects we're the Red Carnation people, remember? We ruined his library thing, and I'm sure he'd love to put us right to work in those mines.
Yes, but despite all reason, Roosterfer loves his son. Strawmen.
They could be looking for him.
Yes, the boy is here. It took you all long enough to notice.
Where, Percy?
He's right over... Pumpkin! Where did Percy go?
I don't know.
He was just here, being really annoying. Percy, are you in the crawl space?
You're playing some tricks.
If only it were a trick. But it is, in fact, very real. Percy is here. And God willing, he won't be much longer.
Go back and tell your boss we have Percy at the boutique, and we'd love to get rid of him more than anything in the world. He's horrible, and we want him out of our lives for good.
Truly.
We tell everything you said.
Good. Don't change a word.
Nice.
Chip, he's upstairs in the residence with Minerva.
Shh, we're watching, little rat skulls.
Sticks and snow can't break your bones.
He's silent.
just sitting there with a saturnine grin.
Are those wax lips in his mouth?
Yeah, keeps him quiet.
Ah, that must be our caretaker with an update.
No, not Bonita.
That's Daddy.
Okay, I told him he could call only if he wanted to apologize for everything he's done, which I think we'd all appreciate.
You gave your personal number to Roosterfer Batsinger.
Well, I didn't think he could use a phone, okay?
Answer the call, but we should talk.
Chip's babysitting.
So, you admit to your dastardly crime?
The only crimes here are from Percy, who has ruined our place of business, in which I assume that's why you're calling.
And what of Percy? Is he fair? He is unharmed?
Yeah, he's fine. Very pleased with himself.
And he has been fed afternoon refreshment?
Well, he ate about 500 Scaramellos in everybody's lunch.
He should already have sweet cake by now. He needs 4 sweet cakes cut crossways with a comic strip. And that's for belly giggles here.
So, do you want him back or not? Because, no offense, but we are sick of this kid, and we want to get rid of him as soon as possible.
Stay your wicked tongue.
What?
Who's on the phone? Is that Daddy?
Yeah, it's your dad. He's going to come take you back to Crudtown.
No way. It's too fun over here.
Percival. Percival.
Oh, great. He's gone again.
Chip, you may think this is a fine gum game, but I'm quite serious. Now state your demands and let us be done.
What? Oh, I don't think you understand.
You intend to leverage young Percy against me, but I say your rebellion has gone too far, sir. This will not answer.
Wait!
Return Percy Joey Josh Batsinger within the hour, or expect my response.
And?
Not good. We have to find Percy right now, or Roosterfer's gonna... I don't know... Uh-huh. That.
Why don't you crank open that window so Julie can stick her head in and say hi to Albert?
Dearie, I'm not in the habit of forcing mule heads inside of little windows of little shacks whose ownership I'm uncertain of.
Well, you wouldn't have to force her head in there. I mean, obviously when she sees Albert, she's gonna want to say hi. Aren't you good girl? She loves Albert.
Bonita, are we certain this is the place? Shall we consult the Muck Forest Resort map?
Okay. We went past the apple-throwing trees, the spooky sauna, and the bewitching pool. These are the guest cabins. This is the top of the hill. What's the name of this cabin?
The Nettlebird.
This is it. Let's go in. Wake up, Albert, wake up.
Bonita, we've tried shaking him. We've tried pleading with him. We've even tried telling him terrible lies to shock him into coming out of his meditation trance.
Albert, Pumpkin pressed a button that's going to zoop us all to the moon. You've got to wake up now!
And none of those tactics have worked. Thus, I do not believe that singing to him will do the trick.
I know. I'm just very impatient to talk to him. Not just to open this stupid caretaker vault. I really want his advice.
Albert is a trusted friend, Bonita, and he is a very wise, very deliberate ghost. It is true.
Oh yes, Albert Ghost, as wise as a valedictorian hoot owl.
What was that, Belfry?
Nothing.
Why are you rummaging around, anyway?
I'm about parched into leather, if you must know. Looking for a jug of switchel, or some quadrille punch or something.
I just have a very bad feeling about whatever this proposal from Roosterfer is. I'm worried that we're going to have to do something really drastic to get our fright power back so we can even try to fight him.
Something like using the illegal loophole to go to Earth?
Something like that, maybe. I know it's a reasonable thing to consider in these circumstances, but it just gives me the heebie-jeebies. No offense, Belfry.
None taken. though it does grieve me that my counselor's caretaker is not welcome to your ears. We can't all be as pure as a floating soap bar, even if Albert squeaks when he walks. Now, since you ain't taking guidance from me, I don't suppose I should tell you about this note I just found on Albert's desk.
Oh! If you are reading this, you are probably trying to wake me up from my meditative trance. Oh, Albert, look at you just planning for all scenarios, you know?
Bonita.
Okay. Due to the deep contemplative nature of this endeavor,
I will not be able to be reached by traditional methods of communication. The intrepid soul who wishes to confer with me will have to calm their mind and join me inside my mind palace.
Oh, crap.
This may prove to be a challenge.
Piece of cake. Okay, calming my mind. Calming my mind.
With a very high expectation.
We'll see.
Okay, now for real. Julie, he's not awake yet, but he will be soon, okay? I just gotta calm my mind.
Roddy, what is that?
A straw man delivered this card. It says, Rustifer J. Batsinger requests an audience to discuss terms of release for precious baby Percy.
Good. Let's get this over with. We did not kidnap Percy. He's here somewhere in the store. He's just hiding because he wants to ruin our lives. That's what we've been trying to tell you.
Gentlemen, I had half a mind to come charging in here with a head full of steam, but then I realized that is exactly what you intended. So I arrive as calm as you please and ask once more, where is my son, and what do you want for his return?
We want nothing but peace from Percy's campaign of terror.
But here's what I think. You all wish me to leave town, that much is clear. And so long as I cannot prove you harbor baby Percy, I can neither harm you nor proceed with my plans.
Is that right? Is kidnapping a good idea?
Even if we wished to kidnap Percy, we would never survive the ordeal.
Just look what he did to the mannequins!
Let us find Percy together, and let this joint endeavor be the foundation of dialogue between our camps.
Chip, you and I have a rapport. We can make a deal. What do you want? Power?
You are not listening.
A companion? Your own luxury stagecoach?
Yes, but...
I see now I was charmed by your dash-fire ways and did not rightly figure you for a two-story man, grabbing innocent babes off the Belvedere under the cover of dark.
I know I didn't do that.
In a way, I'm impressed by your ruthless turn, but if you will not cooperate...
Oh, see
wait,
here.
Wait. I must apply my own leverage to shake something loose.
Come now.
Percy,
be reasonable.
Get out here.
You're mad with worry.
Produce my son before supper, that's 1 hour, or I will zoop the boutique straight to earth. This time, you cannot stop me.
Minerva is still looking for Percy, but we need more help.
Who has experience with children? A firm disciplinarian and master of psychology.
Chipperoo, I don't like you hanging out with that old Roosterfer.
I agree with the sheriff. This is the same man who literally sold our souls for a bag of money. He finds us all expendable, and I wish you to avoid the same path as Belfry.
Guys, I took one carriage ride and texted him one time to ask about the carriage, and he accidentally sent back a selfie up his own nose, and that was it. Promise.
Okay, that's how it starts now. Y'all ain't playing b-ball just yet, but maybe some paper dolls or shadow puppets, and you tell him he done a good one, because it'd be like a wolf, and you say, good one, boy, and then he'd talk about his finger, some old tooth like this here, and then, you know,
Minerva.
He's in the caretaker's office, covered in makeup. Bonita's gonna be...
Percy! What did you do in here?
Nothing. Computer's fried. Back to the shop, Fibula.
Bad boy, baby.
He cleaned out Bonita's candy drawer.
Percy, what do you have to say for yourself?
Nightmare nuggets are good for me.
I'm just glad Julie the Mule wasn't here to see all this, and I ain't gonna tell her about it.
Mm-mm. Okay, Percy, you've had your fun. It's time to go.
No, I'm watching Little Rat School's marathon.
All they gonna tape it for you.
Can we do that? We can do anything to send Percy home.
No!
Yes, Bernice, I'm at the company store again. Come on, keep up. I'm sorry, but you have to be a member to shop here. Unless I sponsor you one time, then you can have a hot dog. But then you have to join the mining concern. It's only fair. No, they don't sell that. You're so bad, Bernice. I told you, I'm here because they're about to unveil the new Country Rock Critter. I don't know. That's why it's so exciting. Here it comes, Bernice. I'll call you back.
Stand back, everybody.
The line starts here. Behind me, everyone.
Here it comes. New Country Rock Critter for hard work.
Just open it already.
Ta-da!
Oh, my word, darling.
You love him.
Oh, my goodness. Is that an owl?
His name, Elmer.
Elmer? That's adorable. What's his deal? What's his story?
He, Halloween owl. He love you.
A ceramic owl with slanty witch's hat, pumpkin pail, and a heart on its bottom. He's perfect.
He's real cute, Miss Weaver.
Pastor Munch, I'm about to meet Elmer because I got the most mining points. Isn't that wonderful?
Oh my, yes. It was such a good decision to come here. And I probably would have got sick from a mine even if I'd stayed at home.
How many critters do you have?
Excuse me, sir. I need medicine.
Okay, cover your mouth, Pastor. Anyway, I have all the critters, even the unsavory ones with cigarettes and lunch pails. And when I get some hands on Elmer, I'm finally going home.
Good job.
The Mine Palace of Albert Ghost. Please remove your shoes and place them in the cubbyhole by the entry bench.
Whoa, I can't believe I actually calmed my mind enough for this to work. This is pretty groovy and so tidy. Why am I surprised? Of course it is.
If you'd like to join me, please proceed to the kitchen. I'm preparing my morning mental everything bagel. It takes a little while to meditate all the poppy seeds.
Coming, Albert! It's me, Bonita! Okay, kitchen. Where's the kitchen? Why can't I move? I'm, like, stuck here. Ugh, okay. Calm my mind.
To proceed, please check the entry door for mental detritus.
Mental detritus? What the... Ding dong! Here I come, and I got taffy on the bottom of my shoes. Ah!
Ding dong! Here I come, Nita! I've emptied everything out of your pocketbook, but I had a very good reason.
Ah, get out of my mind, pumpkin and chip of my imagination. You're giving me the fan tods. Why did I just say that? You guys have to go. I need to talk to Albert.
To proceed, please check the entry door for mental detritus.
Again?
Ding dong, here I come. And I was just going to remind you of that embarrassing thing you said to your science teacher in the 7th grade.
That doesn't even make sense. Belfry wouldn't even know about that. Would he?
No, darling. I'm in your mind.
No. Calm my mind.
Albert! Oh, the kitchen in your mind palace is so cute.
The curtains have cows on them. And look at the jar of candy corn.
463 pieces meticulously placed with my mind. It's good to see you, Bonita. I had a feeling you might show up here sooner or later.
Albert, I'm so sorry to bother you, but the town is in jeopardy in a major way, and I also have this stupid box that I need you to help me open, and I just really, really want to talk to you.
I am flattered that you came all this way just to confer with me. Why don't you have a seat? Let's imagine the kettle boiling, and I'll put on a cup of tea for you. You want blood orange?
Yeah, that's the one I like.
Let's talk. So in conclusion, Bonita, using what I know about the town's fright power infrastructure, I believe you could oust Roostifer as caretaker if you overloaded the grid with a large amount of fright power.
Causing the giant ice cream cone console to overload, which means that Bloopy would allow me to reset it, and I would be the default user. It's so simple, I don't know why I didn't think of it.
Well, simple does not mean it will be easy to enact, Bonita. I understand the town is very low on fright power, and Roostifer has forbidden citizens from trick-or-treating on Earth. It will be difficult to obtain the volume of fright power needed for this plan.
Okay, right. And you know what I'm going to ask you now? That loophole. The weird, shady loophole for visiting Earth that Belfry told me about. If all of this stuff had happened when you were caretaker, would you do it?
Bonita, it doesn't matter what I would have done. You are the caretaker. Your own decision will be valid whatever it is, for it is the result of careful consideration and tough circumstances. That's what leadership is all about, Nita.
Knock knock! Is this the venue for the meeting of the caretakers of Curdle Holler?
Whoa! Hey, mental detritus, I thought the creepy lady voice on the PA told you to stay out.
I beg your pardon, but I haven't the foggiest clue in Swamp Nation what you're talking about, Miss Von Wangencamp.
He's actually here, Bonita. Belfry has joined us in the Mind Palace.
I hope y'all don't mind. You were just taking your sweet time in that there meditation trance. Fred said it would be all right. He's keeping an eye on us.
We don't mind. In fact, I believe we are ready to open the caretaker's vault. Bonita?
Yeah, let's do it.
Now, how does this creepy little contraption work?
These three indentations between the knuckles of the demon hand. We each put a thumb there.
All right.
And push in. Whoa, here we go. Here it is. Scroll of proposed changes to town. Oh, that jerk.
Would it trouble you to read it aloud? I believe I left my good reading glasses in the cart with Julie.
It's a town form. Form Iota Scythe. That's a new one. There are a bunch of long form fields, and all this looks like Roostifer's weird curly old man handwriting. Proposed changes to the town. He says, at the stroke of midnight on Halloween, all of the town contained within the borders of Company Holler and all other land parcels identified on the map below will be forfeited to the Earth Realm. Yeah, and the map shows pretty much everything in town.
Which parcels would be exempt from the move to Earth?
Looks like the library and Vexco Stadium. Like, that's it.
That old snake.
And then finally, other considerations, colon, let it be true that, dot, dot, dot. He wrote, Bonita von Wangencamp can be caretaker of the stadium and the library and be the lady boss of any citizens who wish to create ramshackle dwellings in the stadium or the library. This is just insulting, am I right?
Seems he really thought he was doing something here.
Well, that does it. Albert, thank you so much for helping us open this gross and infuriating caretaker vault. And thanks for the tea and the talking, but I've got to go find Rooster for Bat Singer and kick him right in his wizened old bat camp.
We'll stop stomping on your seats, Albert, and I do apologize for the intrusion. You got a lovely mind, Palace.
Please let me know if I can provide further assistance.
Oh, I will. Oh, crap, did you hear that?
It sounds like someone else has entered my mind palace.
Count Fangula, is that you, son? Good night,
Julie!
Julie. How'd you get him?
I told you, she loves Albert.
Yes, Tarantula. They're setting the new critters up right now. It's an owl, and he's darling. You gotta be jealous. There's no way around it. Yes, your grandson can play with the critters. No, he can't take them to school. That's crazy, Tarantula. They're gonna get glue and pencil shavings all over my babies. You need to apologize. Okay, okay, gotta go, gotta go.
Let's see. That's gonna be 1,000,000,005 mining points.
Here you go.
Here, Elmer. He loves you.
Oh, my word. Elmer, it's a pleasure to meet you. I'm the Widow Weaver, but you can call me Mommy. And we're going home to the most beautiful house in town.
Hi, Miss Weaver.
Thank you. Goodbye, everyone. If you work a little harder, you can go home just like I am. I know you can do it. Straw Mans, I want you to mail my belongings to 866 Mandible Lane, okay? I love you. Bye.
Not so fast.
Excuse you. I'm trying to leave. I'm victorious over the mines.
No. You ain't going anywhere.
What? Don't be silly. I'm going home and I'm going to write a letter about my experience so all my friends have the 411 about you two straw bullies.
Nobody leave.
Unhand me, you jokers. This isn't fair. I'm your best employee.
We know.
Chip, Bonita, I need your help.
Who that?
Help. This isn't fair. Look what they're doing, Elmer. It's not fair. They're cheating. Tarantula. What they're doing! Somebody help! You're not doing anything to help your best friend! What's going on?
He zooped the boutique?
Nita, I know what you're thinking. You're thinking that sounds bad, and it does, and then you're thinking it looks bad, and it does. Basically, it's bad.
Regrettably, the boutique is no more. Roosterfur followed through on his threat to remove it to the Earth Realm.
There's just a little smoking hole where it used to be. My office, our inventory, Rochester's favorite tea set, and even Chip's stupid car lot. All gone.
Now, Miss Von Wangencamp, on the bright side, we got to report that nobody was injured, ma'am. You know, no bodily harm. Y'all can make a new boutique, but we can't replace our precious friends. Isn't that right, Venus?
Venus, you didn't get zooped! Did any people get zooped over? Just the stuff, right? In the building?
That appears to be the case, Bonita. Everyone at the boutique is safe, and their bones are all accounted for.
Everyone except the little scamp who caused this problem in the first place. This was all Percy's fault.
I heard my name.
You! If you don't flap your little wings back over to Company Holler right now, you will be very sorry.
I'm gonna tell my daddy you threatened me.
Good. Make sure you also tell him he can take this stupid box back and go pound sand. And that we opened it, and that we know he's trying to zoop the whole town over on Halloween, which is very rude, and that I want nothing to do with him. Get out of here.
I don't wanna.
Guys, are Buddy and Susan around?
They might be at school. Do they do that?
I don't know.
They often play in the dumpster behind the store.
That sounds right. Buddy and Susan, if you can hear me, come here.
There's a kid here who says he's never played Pat the Kitten before.
Really? You gotta be joking.
New kid's the kitten.
Come here. You're the kitten. Time to pat you. Pat.
You won't pat me. I'm going home.
Nice job, Madam Caretaker.
Oh, Ronnie. I've got to tell you guys all about that stupid caretaker's vault. Roostifer wants me and Belfry to agree to let him zoop almost all the town over to Earth on Halloween. And now he's disappeared our boutique? That was fiendish. That's it. I was on the fence, but I don't care anymore. I'm going to use the weird Batsinger loophole, and we're going to Earth. And we're going to get so much fright power. And we're going to use it to take down Company Holler.
Yes, ma'am. We gonna do it. We gonna do it. I promise you that. But you taking this pretty hard, Bonita. I'm worried about you.
Yeah, Nita. The vein that pops out on your forehead has a vein on its forehead. We're concerned.
Do I hear the approaching thud of Pumpkin's flat, heavy footfalls?
Oh, no. He's gonna be upset, too. He loved this place.
Pumpkin, buddy, come here and talk to us. Don't look. It's real bad, bud.
What do you mean? My business.
We're real sorry, buddy.
Pumpkin, hey. We're gonna get it back. I promise.
It was Pumpkin Store.
Yeah, it was.
Hold my hand.
Thanks so much again, Mr. Goliath. I don't know what we would have done tonight without a place to sleep. Which feels so weird to say.
Bonita, the thought of your charming boutique hurtling through space and time was simply too much to bear. You are welcome to stay as long as you need in one of my well-appointed guest rooms.
I call the ensuite bathroom.
I think we can all agree that I should get the ensuite bathroom.
There is no ensuite bathroom. We will all have to share the hallway lavatory. But don't worry, I have plenty of extra toothbrushes.
Ooh, what color's mine?
Yellow. Bonita, yours is blue.
Okay.
Mine is aqua, and Belfry's is turquoise.
Easy to remember. Okay.
On your beds, you'll find a trashy novel and stuffy from my personal collection. Towels are in the forbidden closet, and breakfast is served at 7 sharp. But get there early, because Belfry's a good eater.
Thanks, Mr. Goliath.
It is apparently time for midnight walkies, and so I bid you pleasant dreams. I'll see you in the morning before your mission to Earth.
You know it.
Good night.
I got the doggy bags.
Oh, bravo. You were able to open them.
Yeah, you got the claw on.
Chip, let me have your toothbrush.
Okay, remember, it's turquoise.
Oh, that's so funny.
Now, good night, and get some sleep. I don't want you grumpy and whiny when we're doing stuff on Earth.
Nita?
What?
I can't go to Earth tomorrow.
Chip, I'm going to bed.
No, I thought really hard about this, and I'm going to go talk Roostifer out of those plans you found. And don't give me that look. I think it's a good idea. You'll see.
Why in the world do you think it's a good idea to talk with Roostifer Batsinger?
Well, you know we have a weird connection. I think he'll listen to me. I think he's impressed by me.
So what? You're going to be like his apprentice now?
Well, he did say, if I learned the business down to the ground, I could come on as a foreman, but I really should have had years of practice as a bobbin boy.
I knew this was weird. I wasn't going to say anything because it sounded rude and hateful in my head, but I knew this is exactly what was going to happen, Chip. You're not talking to Roostifer. That's what he wants. He's using you. Can't you see that?
Maybe, but I still think I can change his mind.
Chip, listen. Roostifer wants you to think that you can talk to him because he knows you always see the good in people. That's why everybody loves you and you're so annoying. But deep down, you know you can't change him.
I have to try, though.
Why?
To keep us from going down a path we can't come back from.
You're going down that path right now, Chip. This guy is dangerous. You don't have to do this to feel important.
Hey, I'm not jealous that you're the caretaker.
Okay. I know that, Chip. I didn't say you were.
I'm a geologist. Everybody's talking about it.
I know.
We're back early. Goliath was on fire tonight.
y'all in there kissing, y'all need to wrap it on up.
Okay.
Very funny.
You'll sleep on it, right?
Yes. We can discuss it in the morning.
Well, if y'all don't mind, I'm going to use the facilities for my nighttime ministrations.
Better grab the toothbrushes.
Right behind you.
Y'all playing too much.
Oh, we hate your house.